Everyone born in this world wants to live a good life, a happy life. And that's the desire of every human being. But then life goes through lots of ups and downs, and people take decisions based on circumstances. Welcome to this program of Purpose of Life. We're going to talk about a lot of real life situations, real life issues. But more than anything, how do we live a good life? Joining me in the studios today is Isaac Joe, songwriter, composer, speaker. Let's go meet him and let's find out what these real life issues or what answers he can provide for real life issues. Isaac, nice to meet you.
Yes, sir. Nice to meet you too.
It's always a pleasure when we talk. One of the things which I like talking with you is people, you know, when they watch a story or serial, you know, it's acting. But here, it's real life.
Correct.
You know, but people seem to like someone acting, you know. But when it comes to real life, it's real hardcore life, you know, and we talk about real things. But why do you think people like artificial things, you know, like there's nothing wrong in movie or art, or it's all part of creation. But people tend to be drawn more towards something which is not natural. What's your take on that?
Yeah, that is where the entertainment, art, everything comes, no? Suddenly you see a guy flying from one terrace to another terrace, exciting. But that doesn't happen.
Correct.
And if the kids try to do, you know what will happen. But the unreal, imaginary world, it helps people to expand their thinking, and which is not normal. So that is where the excitement is to watch.
It draws a lot of crowd and
yes,
you know.
So sometimes you need to know that this is an entertainment, this is not to be applied in real life. Certain things don't work.
Yeah, but talking about real life, Isaac, but real life itself is really exciting in a sense, but it's exciting for those who look at it in that way. It's tough for those who look at it in another angle. How do you respond to that point? People, some people say they look at a kind of an obstacle as an opportunity. Some people look at obstacle as a obstacle. Some people find it tough, they say, especially in this last two few years we have seen. Everything has changed. Today morning, as I read, you know, a lot of sectors are closing down and people are losing jobs. But so how do you respond to this situation of a crisis?
Okay, if you ask me personally and you still want me to be real, nothing to impress the audience, nothing is a shock, nothing is a surprise. Everything has been already predicted, and such similar situation have happened in the past. And there are lives of people whom God has led them to be victorious. So the question, if you want to choose God's principle, you will make it through the storm. It's always. That faith will make you go through that. But if you don't have that faith, then you're going to think the whole world is fallen apart. Just an example of Isaac, when he was in those days, the famine came. And the whole country or the town or wherever that particular world was, everybody wanted to run away to Egypt. Naturally, there's nothing growing, nothing happening, then we can't die there. But God is telling Isaac, you don't move, let them go. But I am the God, even in the midst of the famine, I can bless you. So it's not the circumstances. He can make a fountain in the desert. No, so he says, if they're going, go. But you don't go. In the famine land, I'll bless you 100%.
Why did God rather, or Isaac, what was so special about Isaac?
I think more than that, everything is special about you and me and our viewers to learn that lesson for their life, for their future. But of course, Isaac was always special. He comes from Abraham, whom God has promised his progeny. So he's a part of that generation. And father also, son also, they've all been instructed by God, and they've learned to obey God, and they saw the surplus blessings. God has designated his people, mark on them. So the law is different. Even though it's going to be a bad situation, God sees some good will come out of it. That's why he says, even all things will work together for the good of them that love him. So people who don't love and care about God, it's a different happenings that are going to follow. But when you love the Lord, God will change. That is where your life becomes so exciting and adventurous. To a level, people think it's imagination.
how do I come into this list of God's favor?
Mm.
You know, that because, see, for God to tell Isaac, you know, you don't go, stay. I'll make you a blessing in the place where people think it's famine. So that requires a certain attachment and affection, no? For God to have on Isaac and Isaac to have on God. So how do I come into that realm?
See, God also wants to experience that 100% glory goes to Him. To showcase His glory, no?
Mm.
Somebody has to obey. Somebody has to obey God at His word, just like Noah.
Mm.
For Noah, he's not even seen a droplet or a raindrop. Where is he going to imagine flood? Obeyed. And he saw. So God is needs one obedience without understanding.
Obedience without understanding.
Because you may not understand it immediately. Sometimes we understand it later. I wish we enjoyed it more. I was wondering, but see how God has done beautifully. So God expects that implicit obedience. That practice goes on.
Mm. How did you find that obedience, Isaac?
See, when I say, I also have to include this part of it, that God is the one who initiates the work. That's why I'm also able to go that path. So I can't say that I took a great decision and I obliged and I aligned with God. I'm a great. No, for my brain to even to repent is God's grace. So saying that, I will not negate a person's responsibility. I need to oblige with God, no? Also, there's a will there. So in my life, it was a very hard decision to give up my music. For me, for some maybe drugs, for somewhere, some people it can be a relationship or money. For me, my music was almost like a person. I loved it so much. And for me to give up was the most difficult thing.
So there is a giving up, something you sacrifice or give up. To go to that level, is that what you're saying, Isaac?
God can bring. See, for God says, give up your son. That son for whom, how many years he waited?
Yeah.
And then he says, put him on the altar. That's a very, very difficult thing. And he obeyed. And then God says, I tested you. Now I'm going to bless you. So before the blessing, there is a test. You see, this is what we see, no? How Joseph overcame. He was not... because he was in a foreign land, he didn't live his life the way he would have lived like any other person. No, he was having a very deep conscience of, consciously he was committed to please God, not to cheat his boss and listen to the evil advice of the boss's wife to commit adultery with her. She was trying to do it 365 days. But the young man said, no, I won't go against God, I won't go against his boss also. So that kind of integrity and holiness and consecration, he proved it naturally because of his love and obedience. And it's not about the result. It's, I don't want to grieve God. I want to please Him. So you see, all these guys were God pleases.
And it takes a little time, Isaac, because for doing that, Joseph was punished rather than getting a promotion.
Hmm.
So we have to, you know, I mean, it's not that for good things you are punished, but generally, you know, it takes a little sacrifice to stand apart, right?
Yes, yes, see, but again, the good thing we have to learn is, it's not always green.
Mm.
You do good, but you've been blamed. So when you go through such situation, will you still be faithful? That's a test. When everything is fantastic, everybody will be thankful to God. When things are not moving, things are going in a bad way, and yet in the midst of that, I will still bless God, I'll be faithful to Him. And that is the real faith, and your connection with God is a genuine thing. It's not a fair weather friends, no.
Mm. So you look, you're talking about God being real and genuine in that approach of how He likes you or loves you.
He also tests whether you are genuine.
Mm.
So the test is, no, He will allow you to go through that, and He will be so proud. I don't know what is on the other side happening. I can only get a clue that he and the Satan and devil, you know, devil and God, they had a little debate, and the Lord was so proud, so confident. It's like a horse race, no, banking, betting on the horse, telling, you go check my son, you can't do it. Only thing, don't try to kill him, touch his life. do whatever it is, because that guy was telling, because you blessed your son so much, he is nice to you. If he is not blessed, he may not be nice to you. Okay, let's take it up. So he was not only for the blessing, genuinely he loves me. How to prove that? So the whole drama took place, and Job didn't know what was happening behind the scene. He could have thought God is mad at me or something, but the genuineness came out. So I think during our sufferings, our faithfulness must come out. And we must take every opportunity to say, God, you know, I'm going through, but I want to tell you, I want to be faithful to you, Lord. I want to give that to you as an offering to respect you, that glory goes to you. And God, he likes people who take a stand for him. That's what, when you read the Bible, we notice.
So taking a stand for God amidst whatever situation we are in, I think that's the key. We're going to go into a song of what you have sung and composed. After that, we'll have more questions for you. For friends, we are watching Purpose of Life. Let's see this song and come back with more questions.
Vindicate me, Lord, I leave it with you. Vindicate me, Lord, I've no one but you. Vindicate me, Lord, I leave it with you. Vindicate me, Lord, I've no one but you. If I make a move, I lose my cool. Remind my heart, purify my lips. None can stand your glory. None can stand your fury. Plead my cause, O Lord. Vindicate me, Lord, I leave it with you. Vindicate me, Lord, I'm no one but you. Vindicate me, Lord, I'm no one but you. Vindicate me, Lord, I leave it with you. If I make a move, I lose my cool. Purify my heart, purify my lips. Be my rock of glory, none can stand your fury. Plead my cause, Lord.
Welcome back to Purpose of Life. We are talking with Isaac Joe. Isaac, just this last 10 minutes went with a lot of interactions, but I think one takeaway which I really find is, before God takes pride in his in showing that he is my son or he is my daughter. Just the thought of it itself, you know, makes me think, for God to take pride, there's a test also attached to it, right? It's like writing an exam. Or so tests are not meant to pull somebody down, but if we don't love God the way we really are to prove that test, it can pull us down. How do you look at that statement? Because we are humans, we tend to make mistakes. So, but still the test is there, and I'm sure tests are for you, for me, for viewers. So how do we evaluate every test as a sign that I can get more closer to God in this test? What's your take on that?
See, a test is a very fair test. It's a very fair opportunity for you to climb the ladder. You can pass the test.
But there's some work which we need to do.
There is everything, you know, there's an equal opportunity to deny, to murmur, to do every kind of thing, but
correct.
You have made yourself, this is my life. In this situation, I want to touch the heart of God. This is another opportunity where to prove my faithfulness. So, in your sufferings, instead of murmuring, you start praising God and thank God and see the other side, then it becomes a sacrifice of praise. It's go to another level of real praise. Mm-hmm. Praising God and happy, in your happy mood is different. When you go through difficulties and yet I will only do that, that is something.
Have you experienced that, Isaac, when you find that maybe
yes.
in difficult circumstance, financial crisis, how do you really praise God in
see,
that situation, Isaac?
That is one example I will tell. I used to be preaching, in those days they used to call me to handle a session on praise and worship in a Bible college.
Mm-hmm.
So one of my favorite verses, always I keep repeating in every conversation, my life, it is part of me. In this situation, I was traveling to Mahabalipuram in the night around 11:30, 12. My bike was going in the max possible speed. Okay. Then it ceased. And I was in the air, and the person who was sitting behind, he came and fell on my knee, and my knee broke. I know why, because I tried to get up from the road, my knee bent this way.
Oh.
See, the knee bends this way, but it bent that
oh.
way. When I tried to, then I knew something totally
wrong.
So what has happened when I fell down, what was my first word? Spontaneous. That is, I didn't think. I shouted in the dark high road, those days, no? In the night it will be dark, and my only motorbike headlight was, it was roaring, and once it died, the whole road becomes dark. This is the situation. So, without thinking, no, I just realized it's a test or something, I don't know. In few seconds, nothing to even decide, no, I shouted 3 times loud. I will bless the Lord at all times, and His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Devil, whatever you try to do, I will yell all the more. I will yell all the more. And I shouted 3 times. I will bless the Lord at all times, and His praise shall continually be in my mouth. I will bless 3 times.
And this just came out spontaneously. I mean, anything could have happened, Isaac.
It was a serious accident.
Anything could have happened.
And when I shouted 3 times and lifted up the name of the Lord, and I don't know what happened. And I couldn't stand to pick up the cards that fell off my pocket. Then a lorry came, a sand lorry. They put me there. Then we came to the city. And I was throughout the time praising God. And they rolled me into the theater. And then they said, your leg x-ray, no fracture, nothing. I said, what? Then I realized, in between the hospital and the place where the accident took 1 hour time, no, I was only praising God. So praise can bring a healing. If it can bring the doors, locks, chains to be broken without the ceiling collapse, freaky earthquake, God is able to do it. So it was a very spontaneous thing that happened. Of course, other situations also. My daughter, when she died, she came back alive. I saw that. In two and a half days, almost third day, she came back alive. They said, you'll have to take the body back if she doesn't come alive. Till then, we'll put her on the ventilator. So, these are the things I've been through, which has built my faith. Those path of suffering and tears. You will never get those things from an university by reading books, sorry. So, that's why I think sometimes adversity can be God's university.
Do you think God allows it purposefully, or do you think
God allows is not a big deal, no, even only thing. You never died. You came as a better person with a rich experience which you can never get from an university. So that's what again I said, no,
yeah.
Sometimes our adversity is like God's university.
So it's an opportunity for us to
I'm telling you now, front of everybody, no, I can't go and prepare this. So what happened in my time of crisis, Christ was always there. He did something. He taught me. He didn't allow me to be destroyed. And that's why a champion.
But you could have also been very bitter or saying, why this happened to me? Or many people ask that question, no? Even in this pandemic, we find loss of a life or change of a job. Or
yes.
People saying, you know, why is it happening to me?
You heard me preach.
Yeah.
Don't keep asking why. There's no end to it. Ask what's next.
Mm.
This why question, somebody died in the house, grandfather died, grandmother died, child died, somebody died, dog, pet died. Why? You keep asking why. You will never get an answer, or I must give you something to just console you. It can be a bluff. But let's take it. No? That is world. That is reality. Things will happen. So let's move forward. and let's do what I need to do. I think quite a warrior sort of makeup must come, toughness.
Mm.
What do you say?
Yeah, I think
you can't be crying and whining and blaming God like a kid, no. No. God knows, God permits, God allows, God has a purpose. I'm thankful I'm alive.
Mm.
Like that, you must see the other side of it.
Mm.
We all go through problems, but problems only have made us closer to God. Something good has come out from that. It has never destroyed us.
And the test actually, in a sense, as you rightly said, Isaac, you know, it can, it's taking us to another level or another dimension. I think that's an angle which, it's an angle which moves us to the next phase,
yes,
you know.
Yes, yes. After that test in your life, after that maybe the shame or disappointment, always see there'll be a promotion in your life, upliftment. Mm. You'll go to another level, definitely.
What would you say for people who lose the test? What would be your take on saying, okay, maybe they've lost the test, but there's a comeback. How do you react to that?
Always, no. Just like education, try it again. Another way it will come. And that's why, you know, when people are with the people like what we are talking, they'll automatically grow.
Mm.
When you're around people who are just talking, they're negative and again, it's infectious. So the next time you have reference and seeing people, you read books of life history of people, you read about Nelson Mandela. Oh, Nelson Mandela was in, he was not a bad man, but he was thrown there, so unfair. For 27 years, and that place where he was thrown in, they welcomed. That is, that's the way he welcomed, that's a style. The warden in Foden, in an island, no, you know, that
Robben Island.
Robben Island. Then the words they said is, welcome, once you come, you don't go. You are finished here. This has been a history. That means you're going to die here. But the man survived. It didn't happen by just like a miracle, but he was mind prepared. He never allowed those fellows to break him.
So a lot of mental toughness.
Definitely.
So more than the physical alertness, mental toughness is...
both will go together.
Both
but will go. More is the mental toughness. The mind is... if you break a person's mind, you break everything. Even when you fight intimidation, no, you already won. That's even, why do I go to the worldly Bible? Goliath was trying to talk all trash talk and intimidating. He told him, I'm coming in the name of God. I'm not coming with a sword or a, you see what I'm going to do. I'm going to have you for breakfast. Finished. So that kind of a toughness is based to see through my God. You don't have my God. I have God. I have the advantage. So it's easy peasy, I'm going to finish you. He's just talking, but this guy knows it's a reality. So the mind toughness, I think mental toughness is created by putting your whole trust in the word and the promise of God.
So the trust factor should be 100%. That's what you're saying.
Yes.
Even in that accident scenario, anything could have happened, but then...
I didn't know, no. I didn't think it was involuntary, that was full. See, what is inside you comes out.
If bitterness is inside, then it comes out.
You heard me preach a picture, or I put a picture of an orange and said, if you get an old lady to squeeze an orange, what do you get? Orange. You put that on a sophisticated machine and squeeze it.
Still.
You put it under a running lorry, it gets smashed. What comes out? The change doesn't happen. Whatever it is, what is inside comes out. So that's why we need to fill us up with faith, read the lives of people who have just been warriors and victors, conquerors and champions. And this doesn't happen overnight, no. If you ask me, I've been a timid person, I've been so shy, I've been so isolated, scared to speak. From there I've seen a progress in my life. That's why I can give hope for every shy person. A person is not so good now, but I know he can become fantastic. Why? I was like that. If I can change, I can encourage the person to change. So nobody is born ready-made stuff. We go through the process.
Mm-hmm.
Then you come out beautiful. If you are misguided, then we interpret the whole life differently.
Isaac, in closing, we just have maybe one more minute. For today's viewers, from all what we have spoken, one thing I learn is, you know, what is inside comes out outside. And secondly, in all circumstance, have the trust is what you said. But just to summarize the whole thing in the last minute, what would you tell our viewers who are going through this this obstacle or challenge in front of them? Because we all go through challenges, but it's how you look at the challenge. So, last 1 minute, your take for them.
Correct. See, I feel we first must not underestimate ourselves. Every viewer, I want to tell you, you are a champion and a strong person, because when God is with you, no man can be against you. So, first of all, me and my God, we can handle it. And whatever your problem is, try this. I want to speak to God. I want God to come into the scene. I want you to help me, Lord. I want to stand still and see what you are doing. Give homework for God. And you see, whether it's finance, health, anything. Don't go around the world panic, asking the whole world to pray. Because God knows. And just commit to God and keep praising Him in advance, telling God, you are going to do this for me. Because you are a prayer answering Father God. I thank you, Lord. And have that peace. And be thankful in anticipation. And you will see a miracle, a small miracle come. After that, you will be so confident. You say, this works, man. I'll apply this in everywhere. So, I only really wish you that you will become a spiritual person. Understand your spiritual roots. And start being a person who will handle anything, asking and involving the Lord. And it's not like a religious prayer. Because you talk to Him as your father, friend. And He will do it for you. And keep thanking God. He is going to do fantastic things and you will see victories. And you will also sit down and tell everybody like what I am talking.
Isaac, it's been a pleasure talking to you. More than anything, we are going to do more programs based on this. Because I personally feel these are practical talk, real life situations. And I think many viewers will definitely get blessed as we speak.
Yes.
Thanks for joining us. Next episode, we'll talk more on the practicalities of life. How do I move from a good life to a more happy life?
Correct.
And we'll talk about that topic.
Yes, how to progress into another step of blessings and seeing new things bloom in our life.
Yes, we'll talk about that.
I'm excited.
Yes, thanks, Isaac. Friends, for those of you watching, there's a number there. We want you to talk to us. Tell us how this program is, because your response will make us create more content. So therefore, write that number down, call us, text us, and let us know how we can help you. Thank you for watching us. May God richly bless you.